Mr. Jobris P. Olbes is a graduate of Bachelor of Arts in Political Science and proceeded to finish Bachelor of Laws at the Palawan State University. He assumed the post as Corporate Secretary of the Philippine Pili Industry League Incorporated, or PhilPili, in 2016. Hanilyn A. Hidalgo, Associate Professor 5, Department of Agribusiness, Central Bicol State University of Agriculture. Dr. Jonathan Aguilar, Associate Professor and Water Resource Engineer, K-State Research Extension, Kansas State University, USA.
Pili is endemic in the Philippines, particularly in the Bicol region. Pili is a pride product because no other country produces pili. It is the flagship commodity of the Bicol region and is considered a tree of hope because of its various uses of its different parts and its different processing and utilization possibilities. Bicol region accounted for more than 80% of the total number of pili fruit-bearing trees in the Philippines, hence making Bicol the country's major pili producer. Pili nuts are sold domestically and internationally. However, the pili nut shell is one of the bio-waste products left behind by pili nut production in the Bicol region. Using the concept of bio-circular economy, our team will utilize the pili nutshells and transform them into a valuable product for food processing.
On the sufficiency of drinking water, majority of families with 85.2% reported that drinking water was sufficient. However, 4 in every 5 families with 78.8% did not practice any method or treatment in ensuring their drinking water is safe to drink.
Across region, BARMM has 74.6% had the lowest portion of families with access to basic drinking water services, followed by Zamboanga Peninsula has 84.3% and Bicol region has 87.0%.
Here in Bicol region, 187,673 people did not have safe drinking water, and 30% of more than 5 million Bicolanos get water from dug wells. Cholera infection result from water and food contamination. The proximity of water sources to toilets and waste were possible reasons for contamination in this outbreak, as heavy rain flooded these wells.
For our team's vision, this project invites to introduce the pili nutshell as one as alternative water purifier. And for our mission, to produce sustainable supply of potable water, particularly upland areas of Bicol region, and to generate new innovative way of utilizing the bio-waste product of pili nut industry.
As tourism is slowly recovering, our pili nuts will be mainstream not just as a nut, but as an essential oil. This means that a lot of pili nut shells will be put to waste. As agriculture and business students, we will take the lead in developing pili nut shells as an alternative purifier in food processing. Our multidisciplinary team, agribusiness, agriculture, and education, will be a good mix for the project because we will integrate enterprise skills, agriculture competencies, and social development skills in the project. Some studies show the pili nut shell as potential source of active carbon, which can be used for water purification. Using pili nut shells as purifiers in food beverage production can reduce the use of synthetic and expensive purifiers.
The carbonized product can be activated by using a physical or chemical activation method. The physical activation method is a traditional method to produce the activated carbon. The drawback of a physical activation is must yield is poor and requires the higher temperature for the activation process. Chemical activation is carried out by pre-carbonized materials with carbonized agent and pyrolyzed between 400 degrees Celsius and 853 degrees Celsius in the absence of oxygen.
The pyrolysis and activation of CGT. The prepared CGT was carbonized inside a completely sealed horizontal steel tube, that was the so-called Schedule 80 reactor. Inside the reactor was a steel tray holder containing 100 grams of prepared sample. To optimize the pyrolysis condition for char production, samples were pyrolyzed at different temperature settings at 600, 700, and 8000 degrees Celsius for 30, 45, and 60 minutes. The horizontal tube type furnace or thermalite model number 79300, whose length and inside diameter were 21.50 and 3.0 inches respectively, was used to supply heat and to the system.
The shells were crushed, washed, and dried, affording brown, flat, and irregularly shaped particles, particularly 30 grams to 2 to 4 millimeter size. The shells were packed in air to full capacity into a sealed vessel, tightly closed for carbonization process. The purifier will use an 8x30 mesh and 12x40 mesh of granular active carbon filling shell. Since the raw material is organic, the flow rate is approximately 1 GPM per cubic feet to 2 GPM per cubic feet. The water will be tested first in order to identify its pH level. If the pH level of the water is above neutral, which is 7.0, then the carbon bed must increase in 20%.
Our project will prioritize the three sustainable development goals. First one, SDG 3, good health and well-being. This project can help in addressing the health issues caused by lack of clean, potable water in upland areas. Second, SDG 6, clean water and sanitation. The project aims to generate new innovation that can resolve the scarcity of potable water in rural areas. Lastly, SDG 8, decent work and economic growth. This project can introduce in various livelihood programs, such as in Pili and coconut oil production for unemployed citizens in various municipalities. Moreover, the project can also be an alternative equipment that can lessen the production costs of small businesses.
This project can reduce the expenses in food processing production, since it will use more accessible purifier. Making organic purifier will also give another opportunity of Pilinat farmers and for the whole community. In addition, this will highly influence the profit in cost of productions of small enterprises. Thus, they will also create job opportunities, especially in our rural areas where farming is the main livelihood sources. In this small action, the team can already empower the disadvantaged people in municipalities in the Bicol region, because it resolves the waste material left by Pilinat Productions. It will also promote organic way of purifying food and beverages. It will also beneficial for farmers as well. Moreover, this project becomes a successful, it will also promote the conservation of sustainable environment by planting trees and farming. With all of this, we can help our environment to become more sustainable, give people more job opportunities, empower and small enterprises, and most especially, turn an unclean water into a drink one.
Our project is very important, more especially in our environment. Our project is environment friendly. Unlike the use of bottled water, filtering your used water to make them usable again is not just beneficial to your pocket, it is also beneficial to the environment. This because you will not need to buy a bottled water whose disposal is a source of pollution to the environment. Hence, filter your water and you get to save your money and save your world at the same time. There is no doubt that water filtration is safe, cost-effective, and also beneficial to the environment. Hence, begin to enjoy the benefits of having a water filtration system today. The benefit is too good to overlook. You probably thought it was a complicated thing before, but as you can see, filtration is not a complicated thing at all. Go for a filtration system that best suits your need.
We are the Team Pilifiers, and we are from the Philippines!